Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He years ago, amen, even though he came up in a sanctified church. Amen. And amen. The talk around town was the sanctified people don't mix with the Baptist. Can I preach in the house? Can I be real in the house? Amen. Amen. And amen. What I like about him, amen, just like myself, amen. And see, amen, I see no denomination.
My Lord.
Amen. All I see is a vessel of God. Amen.
Yes, amen.
Amen. And, amen. The Lord, amen, amen, bless him to blaze the pioneer trail. Amen. Amen. He didn't only play on the sanctified side of the fence, but he moved over in the Baptist side of the fence. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And the Lord bless him on both sides.
Yeah.
Huh? Amen. Ain't everybody can go on both sides, huh? And survive. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, amen. They got people and things that they are sanctified. Amen. And amen, but when you take them out of that arena,
all right.
Paul flatters their faith, huh?
Yeah.
Amen. Hello, amen. Got people that are Baptist and Methodist, yeah. And when you pull them out of their comfort zone, they are lost.
Yeah.
But I thank God. I guess some of my anointing must roll off on him. Amen. God, I thank God we can go anywhere at any time. Amen. We can have church.
Amen.
Amen. I learned a long time ago there ain't any denomination. Huh? Amen. But it's whom you, amen, whom you serve, huh? Amen. If you know that you serve the true and living God, you can go anywhere and praise the Lord, huh? You can go anywhere and feel the presence of God. Hello? Amen. You can go anywhere. Huh? Amen. And God not confined to just one nomination. Huh? Amen. He said, go in the hedges and the highway and preach the gospel. Compel men and women to come to Christ. Huh? He didn't say go to the Pentecostal. He didn't say go to the Baptist. He didn't say go to the Methodist. But he said go into all the hedges and the highway and compel them. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So, amen. So, amen. I thank God for him. I always look at him. I ain't told him about it, but I always look at him, amen, and thank God for him, amen. He got enough courage to do something nobody else, Baba, wouldn't do. And look at how the Lord bless.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Nomination. It's just a name.
So good.
When at the end of the day, you're going to have to need to know Jesus Christ,
yes.
His death,
yes.
His burial, and His resurrection.
Amen.
And if you don't know that, I don't care who you are or what you are, amen. You won't know Him.
Yeah.
All
right. Come on. Yeah.
Amen. I thank God for Him, amen. The one that, very, amen, hospitality, and him and his lovely wife, Tammy, amen, when I first met her, amen, she had that same smile on her face. I want to let her know tonight, don't everybody call me Tyler, we are. I thank God for her, amen, tonight, amen, 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 thank God. Now, amen. Now, can we preach tonight?
Go ahead.
Amen. Are y'all going to help me preach tonight?
Yeah.
Amen. I thank God, amen, for, amen, Pastor Yield, amen. We learned him a long time ago, amen, through by his auntie, amen. Brother Fred, mama, amen, sister. Yes, amen. God bless her, amen. That's how we became acquainted with him, huh? Amen. We've been knowing Brother Fred and them long years ago. I was a little boy. He was a young man. Amen. And see, amen, The Lord don't care who he uses and how he uses. All he wants is a willing vessel so that he can use. Amen. And when you allow yourself to let him use you. If the story was told, I believe Pastor Gill was instrumental in a lot of his family members coming to Christ.
Amen.
Been there, done that, Amen. Tonight, from the book of 1 Corinthians, we're going to start by the 9th chapter and go around to the 9th verse. And if y'all bear with me, I'm not going to try to be here long, but if the Spirit, if the Spirit, keep me, then I'm going to stay.
Amen.
But when the Spirit leave me, I got to go out of here.
All right.
Amen. 1 Corinthians 9th chapter and verse 9. Amen. If you don't mind, can we stand and reverence in the Word of God?
That's not an indication.
Amen. But it is written in the law of Moses, you shall not muzzle out the ox. Amen. The ox that thridded out the corn. Does God take care of the ox? Or said he is altogether for our sake. For our sake, no doubt. This is written that he who plies should plow in hope.
Yeah.
And that he that thresh in hope should be partaker of his hope.
Yeah.
If we have sown unto you spiritual things, it is a great thing if we shall reap your karma.
Yeah.
Somebody said, bring on the money. If others be partaker of this power over you, are not we rather?
Yeah.
Nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffer all things, lest we should be hindered the gospel of Christ. Amen. The Bible said the love of money is the root of all evil. Money, and I know this for a fact that Pastor Gill don't let money dictate to him how he allow God to use
him.
I told you, he was right in my shadow, Amen. I don't let it bother me. I know he don't let it bother him.
Amen.
I heard one of the brothers say, that he has a giving heart, And what's so good about that, he don't always stick his hand out to receive back to it, Amen. I'm going to preach in a minute. Do you not know that they which minister about the holy thing live of the things of the temple?
Yeah.
And they which wait at the altar are partaker with the altar. Even so has the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel.
All right.
But I have use none of these things. I'm not, as long as the Lord bless me, as long as the Lord give me health and strength, long as the Lord able me to be to and fro, I don't even depend on the church, My help, I look to the hill from whence cometh my help. All my help coming from the Lord that hath made heaven and earth. Neither have I written these things that it should be so done unto me. But it was better for me to die than that any man should make my glory abroad. For though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of. For the necessity is laid upon me. Yea, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. unto me if I preach not the gospel. Amen. My thought gonna be coming from, amen, the right in the center part of verse 16. For the necessity is laid on me. Amen. I must preach, Pastor Gibbs. Amen. It's in me. Amen. It's in me. I've got to preach, huh? Amen. Because, amen, if I don't preach, there are a lot of men and women that are going to go to hell. Amen. If I don't preach, amen, blind eyes are never going to come open. Amen. And my philosophy is not doing it like everybody else. Amen. Do it like God said you. Amen. I believe that every good preach man or preach woman, amen, shouldn't wait till they get to church to learn how to preach. Amen. I believe that when you're on the fishing bank, amen, I believe you should preach to the fish. Amen. I believe when you're driving down the road, that you should preach to the automobile, huh? Yes. Amen. Why is that, amen? Because practice makes perfect, huh? Yes. Amen. Those people that are listening to you, yes, amen, they need to know something other than Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Yes. Amen. They need to know, amen, that God is still in the delivery business. Yes. How can they hear without a preacher, huh? Yeah. Amen. How can he preach? Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Except he be sin, huh? Yeah. Amen. It's amen. It's necessary for the men and women, amen, to prolong, amen, to propound God's word to you, huh? Yeah. Amen. Sometimes they have to kind of slam it down in your spirit, huh? Amen. Because you're moving, you're a rolling stone, don't care to gather no more, and they have to slam the word down in it. Sometimes they have to come, amen, do the easy and just lay it in there, huh? Amen. But don't care how they do it, they got to preach the spirit, amen. They got to preach the word of God, amen. Because if they don't preach, amen, the devil will come in and he will destroy us, huh? Amen, 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 amen. If the preach man, amen, don't do what the Lord told him to do, huh? Many people will be lost, huh? Because we're living in a time now, amen, to people, they don't really read and study the Bible like they should do, huh? Amen. They believe everything somebody else tell them. Amen. But when, amen, at the end of the day, amen, you got to go into that word for yourself. Amen. At the end of the day, amen, you got to have a relationship with God, huh? Amen. And the preacher man shouldn't have to come to the house of God and make you happy. Because you ought to bring your joy with you when you come up in here. Amen. You ought to know something about Jesus. When I think about the goodness of him, you got to know that he is a reward, huh? A them that diligently seek, huh? You got to know that he's a way maker. Not just saying that, but you got to try him for yourself. I tried him and he working out. I tried him and he made a way. I tried him. He opened that door.
Yes, huh?
Yeah. Amen. That's why. Amen. The preacher man, anybody just can't preach to y'all.
All right.
Huh? Amen. Anybody just can't. Huh? Amen. So when anybody preach to you, you getting a peanut butter and jelly set. Huh? But some of us got big bones, huh? And we need some rice. We need some potatoes. We need some steak. We need some other. Amen. So many times we've been condemned.
Well,
Everything we do, we going to hell. Amen. They said you can't wear this. Can't wear your hair like that. Amen. You got on them loud colors. You are out of God. But God ain't looking at the outward. But God look at the heart. If you got it on the inside of your heart, out of the heart flows the issue of life. And why? In these last days, God is calling for men and women that will stand flat foot and teach the word of God. He was those that will stand flat foot and open up their blind eye. Those that will stand flat foot and let them know, amen, God ain't looking, amen. Because if the truth were told, that what they call sin already been paid for at Calvary. And if it been paid for, why am I trying to get it back? It's a necessity. Amen. That I preach, Amen. And see, amen. Real cream ain't good enough. Y'all wonder why Pastor Gill put it in overdrive sometimes? Because the Lord dealing with it. That somebody out there needs more than a real cream anointing. Somebody out there, the door been closed in their faith, and they right, they one or two words from giving up, Amen. And so the Lord laid it on his heart, amen. Do the next today, my pastor should preach the heart. But God gonna take care of it. Amen. Why is that? Because a necessity is needed. Amen. It's a necessity for me to let you know, amen, you ain't bad off than you think you is. Amen. It's a necessity for me to let you know, amen, that when you really, amen, look down in the word, see, we are shallow water saints. Amen. We read the scripture, amen, and we go and sit down, but amen, but we don't get a good understanding. Amen. We got to dig into the word of God. Amen. And when we dig into the word of God, we got to redig and we got to redig and we got to redig. Amen. Why? Because I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to sit up in the church. Sing in the choir. And in hell, lift up my eyes. Amen. God, I serve his neighbor. He's a true God. He's a way maker. He make ways out of no way. Amen. He bring me out of things that I didn't think I could come out of myself.
Amen.
Look to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, God is good. And all the time, God is good. Paul was saying, amen, that, amen, he was saying that, amen, that we should not muzzle the ox, that threaded out the corn, What, amen, was so, amen, good about it, when I did my study, amen, an ox is a strong animal, Amen, believe it or not, your man and woman of God, are very strong. Amen. And when you try and to deviate the ox, try to muzzle the ox, amen, when you at the end of the road, your road is going to be crooked. So, amen, so you don't want to, amen, do nothing to affect the man or woman of God, amen, and not that they won't tell you, but because of the way that you are acting, you won't allow them to tell. Amen. I've got to decrease so the man and woman of God going to increase. And when they increase, God tells the word. Let the preacher do what God sent him to do. Amen. Let him, amen, teach what God said to do. Amen. And when you do that, Amen. At the end of the day, you won't find yourself slew footed. You won't find yourself bending over, huh? Amen. Listen here. But when we came up, look like they came to church.
Yeah.
And they had bull whips and billy clubs.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And when you came in there, they beated you from the while you came in there till you left out the door.
Yeah.
But I thank God for grace.
Yeah.
The only the thing called grace, yeah. And God will bless me anyhow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even though I don't deserve it. He'll bless me, huh?
Amen,
amen, amen. And so he said, mother out the ox. Amen, that threaded out the corn. Amen, don't get in the way of the preacher. Amen, let the preacher man be himself. Amen, if you don't understand it, amen, ask God to give you understanding. Amen, if you don't know why, amen, quit talking so much, huh? To work somebody put on their britches, huh? Amen. According to some of y'all, amen, he dirty, low down, and he no good, huh? Amen. Let him do what God said do. Even though you might not agree with it all the time, amen, just look toward heaven and say, thank you, Lord. You taking me where I should be. You should be someplace, but you can't be because you ain't doing what the Lord has. I preach in the house, huh? You got to learn how when they start pounding on you, you got to learn how to tell God, I ain't gonna get mad with them, but I thank God you using them to put me where I should be. I thank God that you propping me up to where I so I can stand up. If the word can lift me up, one day I'll be able to stand up. And when I stand up, I let the world know that Jesus Christ, his death, his burial, resurrection. I'm able to walk and talk in the newness of life.
Amen.
Take your hands off the preacher, man.
All right.
Let him go. Take your hands off, huh? Because, amen, we're human too. Can I get a witness? We like to lean and profile sometimes. Can I get a witness? Amen. Sometimes, amen, we like to slow down sometimes. Can I get a witness? Ah, yeah. He did it for you. He just didn't do it for you. He did it for us too. Can I get a witness? When I take off my preach man robe, amen, I'm still a man. Hello, somebody, huh? But long as I'm a man of God, amen, I'm going to preach, amen, until boys chop down their dope. I'm going to preach until the needle put down his needle. I'm going to preach to the jailhouse bar. Come on. I'm going to preach that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. I'm going to preach that man that if you come to Jesus, he'll make everything go. Let me give you this. Amen. If you sit there, look cool, calm, and collected, this thing will pass you by. But sometimes you got to get ugly with it. Sometimes you just got to raise your hand and say thank you. Sometimes you just got to wiggle. Sometimes you just got to rumble and say, God, do some. Hey. Joy. Huh? But the Bible says, if you ain't got no joy, 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 and see, everything don't look political. Correct.
Yes, sir.
Amen. I'm Pastor Johnny O. Longmire. But sometimes, baby, you got to get ugly with this thing. cute. When they take off that maroon, hello? When they take off that synthetic hair, I was dating a lady one time, Pastor Bill, when I was a teenager. And when she was in church, she had that Afro wig on. And I went to her house, and I didn't supposed to go there, but I went anyway. Knocked on the door. She came and she didn't have that wig on. I said, where your sister at? She said, fool, that's me. You got to get ugly with this thing. Amen. Say, if we have sown unto you spirit, it's a great thing to reap. If he lead you from, amen, life, from death to life, you ought to have a given spirit. And let me tell you the secret about God. You can't be God-given no matter how you try. When you give over here, he gonna bless you over there. When you give over here, he gonna bless you back here. When you give in the basement, he gonna bless you on the top floor. You can't be God-given no matter how you try. And then what we got to do, we got to quit saying, I'm giving it to the church. Give it to that man and the woman of God, because they got your life in your hand, in their hand. They're concerned about your soul. When you go home at night and roll over in that bed, the pastor said, Lord, take care of them. She don't know what you're doing, but take care. Bring it up. Heal that body. Make that way out of nowhere. Hold that door for them. Y'all, I know the pastor got an undercover job there. He's the only one that just about know everybody's name in the church.
Amen.
You know that sister that wear that red wig?
Uh-huh.
Oh, you mean Sister Mary, huh?
Uh-huh.
Oh, you know that sister that got them two little boys? Uh-huh. Yeah, you mean Sister Kevin, huh?
Uh-huh.
Hello? Amen. And he realized sometimes when he get there, amen, in a test type mode, they don't do that much.
My Lord.
But amen, sometimes you have to be more harder on you than you are on somebody else.
My Lord.
But then Satan say, he's picking on me.
My
he's
Lord.
Picking on me.
Yeah.
He's picking on me.
Yeah.
He's picking on me, huh?
Yeah.
It isn't that, amen, the Lord already told him where you need to be.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
And what he doing, he's trying to instruct God, amen, do what God told him to do. Lord said, touch up a little bit. Don't let her see ease over his eye. Don't let up on her. Amen. Just tighten it up. Tighten it up. Huh?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, amen, when we do calm thing, amen, then, amen, we do spiritual thing, then you have to bless us with the carnal time. We got all the religion, but we ain't got no money to give. Amen. Okay, amen. Then it said, amen, even so had the Lord ordained me that I should preach the gospel. Pastor Gil was called, and he was ordained by God to preach the gospel. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. How do I know? Amen, when he ministered, I can feel the, amen, the juveniles of God moving, amen, in the building. Amen, I can feel his spirit, his spirit entwined with your spirit. Can I get a witness? Amen, and that spirit, amen, that he got, amen, it just don't only stay to him, but it roll off on you. Amen, every once in a while, amen, I get the feeling this thing so good. Amen. It don't look like the people want to praise the Lord. Don't look like they want to clap their hands. Don't look like they want to do nothing but just sit there like not so long. But every once in a while, I have to look at my bag and say, God brought my thank you Jesus with me. Every once in a while, I have to tell him I brought my glory with me.
know why? I had to move, run, and give me a leap for some joy. Ain't for my benefit, but it's your benefit. Amen, because, amen, it's a necessity that I preach the gospel. Amen, if I don't preach, amen, you never will come out of your way. If I don't preach, oh Lord, they never would know right from wrong. The Bible said, how can they hear without the preacher? We gotta be instant in season out of season. Well, I better do it by myself, cause nobody wanna help me. I got to preach to a little young boy say I wanna see Jesus. I got to preach to the blind eye come open. But to us, we know it's the power of God unto salvation. Because of somebody preaching, one day I came to Jesus. Because of somebody preaching, one day I put down my whiskey bar. It's a necessity. You got to preach. Cause if I don't preach, sin will come in and take control of it. And only because you got a real man of God that sin ain't took over. It only because the man that God called you, the man that God gave you for 19 years, he been preaching God's word. Jesus. And let anybody hear that to believe the prophet, and you shall prosper. Believe in what? You shall be established. I stop by to tell you. Somebody here tonight, they feel the fire, but they won't move.